Hello, deep thinker and lifelong learner. Today, we are actually going to talk about how I went from this one idea, become a sonar technician of ideas, to a collection of ideas and thoughts and rabbit trails and all kinds of stuff. What can you expect? Well, we're going to talk about how to find ideas through synonyms, progressive summarization in HeptaBase, how to stay in deep thinking mode by never leaving the app, even when you need to Google something. And then lots more. To start off, I want to go through the process, okay? About 4 weeks ago, I started watching Hunter Killer, or I watched Hunter Killer, which is about a mission to rescue a kidnapped Russian president and prevent a coup that could lead to World War III. It's a classic action movie, but tucked inside of this movie, I found an idea. And I wanted to explore that further. Now, as I watched this movie, I was intrigued by the sonar technician's ability to hear distinct torpedo and ship sounds. And so I wrote down the idea in the journal. This is a Meta app, one of the Meta apps. If you look over here on the left-hand side, we have all these Meta apps. The journal is one of the Meta apps that makes up HeptaBase. Now, I wrote down the idea in that day's journal, right? Because everything goes in the journal for that day. I also added an article from the Navy on job descriptions of a sonar technician so that I could look into that further as I was thinking more about this idea. Now let's pause real quick and look at this card. This is the card that I created. If I go into the info here, I love how I can see a lot of different things. I love that I can see when this was created, right? On June 26, 2024. If I go into that specific journal date right here, I can see other ideas that I was thinking about. And I can see it's on my weekly review. And I can see it's currently in the workbench whiteboard, where I'm thinking through ideas, and then I can see connections as well, which we'll get into that. But I wanted to point out that it's really cool how when you get something like this, where it's kind of fleshed out and you've got multiple ideas stemming from this one idea right here, that you can see the birthplace of the idea, right? You can go back to the day that you wrote it down, and you can see the ideas that you wrote down on that day together with this idea. It's just super cool the way that HeptaBase allows you to do that. I want to pause just for a moment here and give you a free gift for hanging out with me today. This is a short PDF guide on how to get insights from the nonfiction books that you read and that you love into your PKM system. By the end of this guide, you'll have a simple system for highlighting your books, a mindful approach for adding content to your PKM system or PKM Notes app, a process for creating building blocks of knowledge for the future, and then a simple tip for making more connections between your notes. The link to the free guide is in the description below. Now, when I was ready to start exploring the idea, what I did is I created a new section on the workbench whiteboard. So, for more info on the workbench, you should check out my video on knowledge maps. I'll put that link in the description. So you can see this whole section, become a sonar technician of ideas, right here. I created that section first and then I added this card, the note card, into the section. Now, I pulled up the article on the right sidebar. So in this card, I mentioned earlier that I pasted in a URL on a sonar technician's job description and all about the sonar technician because I wanted to learn more about it. So without leaving the app, I can on the right-hand side come over here, open the sidebar, and I can actually copy this URL and paste it and hit enter. and it pulls up Google for me right here. Okay, so I was in the article and I came across some things that I wanted to put in onto this section right here. So I literally went through and I found things that resonated with me, highlighted it on Google on this web page right here, and just simply pasted it onto the section. Okay, so I've copied and pasted the passages from the article onto the section. The next thing that I did was highlight in bold words or phrases from those passages that stood out to me. So you'll notice on both of these passages, I have an orange highlight in bold here, the things that stood out to me, which were the words identify, tracking, collect, and navigation. And then on this passage here, the words quietly track, gather intel from the depths, and then the word surveillance. So the next thing I did was I took those phrases or words and I created a new text element within this section here and drew connection lines to it. Okay, so let's take a look at quietly track here. I started out saying I love how it describes how the sonar technician should track quietly, like right, quietly tracks. And so some of the synonyms that I pulled up for quiet were silent, still, and noiseless. And the word still, it stood out to me. So I underlined and bolded that. And I thought we too can use our tools, which are note-taking apps, to quietly track ideas hidden within the depths. All right, this is a thought that I had. And then I looked up the word track. The definition is to follow the course or trail of someone or something, typically in order to find them, to note, or typically in order to find them or note their location at various points. Now, the word still reminded me of a verse in the Bible where it says, "Be still and know that I am God." So I ended up searching the words "be still." And now the first highlight was truly the essence of what I was trying to communicate. There's a reason why God invites us to be still first. The stillness makes way for the knowing. I couldn't be more perfect for what I was thinking of when it comes to quietly tracking, right? To be still so that we can follow the trail. So these thoughts under quietly track led to a thought really of be still. Now, I wasn't necessarily looking for this quote, this highlight right here. It just happened to be something that stood out to me as I was searching for with the words be still, because I know I had some notes in there about that. And some highlights. And I really liked the way that she phrased this in this book called The Next Right Thing. And so I thought of this phrase, awareness follows stillness. And so I wrote this down and turned it into a card. I want to have this be a building block in my life of learning whiteboard, right? And I want to continue thinking about this. And as I thought about awareness follows stillness, I thought in the stillness, we follow the trail, right? That's where the tracking comes in. And as we do, as we follow the trail, we discover ideas that help us navigate through life. Okay, so that's one avenue, right? The other path that I was think that stood out to me was this word surveillance. In context right here, sea surveillance is essential to navigation. To surveil is to observe. It's close observation. And I thought close observation is essential to steering your life. And from this card, I was reminded of a quote. And from this card, I was reminded of this quote from Socrates: "The unexamined life is not worth living." Right? Observation, close observation is essential to steering your life. Now, this actually relates really well to this card as well. I want to go back real quick and kind of go over some things. You'll notice I have quite a few of these accordions here, these different searches And they're all, if you can see, they're all Google searches right here. As I was looking up like the word quiet, I literally went over here to the side and typed in quiet definition. And this first option right here is a Google search. So I can hit enter, I can click this, and it's going to pull up Google for me in a way that I can view Google inside of the app Heptabase. So for all these words that I was looking up definitions or synonyms for, it was all done within the app Heptabase. And I can close each of these searches. I can also get rid of them as well. So I have all these searches that I don't necessarily have to start over. If I want to go back and look at the definition of quietly, or track or navigate, or if I want to look at this next right thing quote again, right? It's right there at my fingertips, and I can keep these open as long as I need them while I am thinking through these ideas. Okay, so now we have this passage right here. The sonar technician submarine STS. This is a describing what happens when you actually are on the submarine. So you serve aboard every class of submarine and specialize in combat system equipment where you'll identify, track, and collect scientific undersea data used for boat defense and navigation. So I highlighted identify, track, and collect and navigation. And my immediate thought was we can identify, track, and collect ideas to help us navigate our way through life. I noticed the words identify, track, and collect bumping up against the word navigation. Right? In this context, the sonar technician is doing the work of identifying, tracking, and collecting for the purpose of defense and navigation. There's a purpose of the verbs right here, right? And that's when I had this thought of, we can identify, track, and collect. And what is the purpose of that? Well, it's to help us navigate our way through life. I hope you're catching this out. There are ideas tucked away inside of, so probably something that I would not ever think to look at, a sonar technician. And just because I watched a video or a movie and was intrigued by it, but there are ideas for the things that we care about and thoughts for the things that we topics that we care about inside of completely different industries that we would never think of. Now, by following this process, I've gained clarity on this idea of becoming a sonar technician of ideas. I've not only gained, these ideas right here, but I've gained the connection. I hope this was an encouragement to you to continue to think deeply and to allow ideas to come from anywhere. I would love to hear from you. Let me know in the comments of what stood out to you or what you would like to learn more about in this process of thinking deeply in Heptabase. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.